أشكر اللجنة المنظمة المؤتمر على دعوتي، هربت من ساعة اسكندرية شوية. أشكركم على الصمود، وأوعدكم إن هو اللكشر دي تبقى براكتس سنترد رادر ذان ثيري. We're gonna look today على the current place of sulfonylureas, role of SUs in the management of type 2 diabetes with a focus on glimepiride. And I introduced you to real life patients, Ustaz Nabil and Madame Karima, two real life patients, and we're gonna discuss together what to do for them. Am I gloomy to start with this slide about the chronic complications of diabetes, but this is the fact. The most common cause of visual loss is diabetes. The most common cause of end-stage renal disease is diabetes, and the most common cause of amputation is diabetes as well. And we have evidence that the higher the hemoglobin A1C, the more in the blood glucose level, the more in the incidence of diabetic complications. Well, in good news, data from UKPDS between it is worth to get the A1C lower. For every 1% reduction of A1C, you will get this marvelous reduction of diabetic complications. We all know that we are surviving an epidemic of type 2 diabetes. ولنا ترتيب عالمي في top 10 countries in the number of diabetic patients expected to increase ويزيد كمان وكمان. Let's start work and we're gonna start with أستاذ نبيل. أستاذ نبيل عنده 52 سنة, 2 years history of type 2 diabetes. He is on metformin 1 gram twice daily, BMI of 30, with controlled hypertension and dyslipidemia, and enjoying a blood pressure of 130 over 80. The drugs النبيل بياخدها 2 grams of metformin, amlodipine 5 milligrams, remicrad for control of hypertension, and atorvastatin for dyslipidemia. And this is a glycemic profile of النبيل. So كرصاني 196, postprandial 1051, A1C of 8.3%. واضح ان هو uncontrolled. In as regards the hyperglycemia with well-controlled lipids and the blood pressure. والسؤال الاول, what are the glycemic targets of Mr. Nabil? How low would you like to get his blood glucose low? The guidelines of the ADA, سكر صايم اقل من 130, بعد الاكل بساعتين اقل من 180, A1C اقل من 7%. ال 7% A1C ما هياش appropriate for every diabetic patient. في معظم مرضى السكر ال 7% دي reasonable target, ولكن اذا كان مريض of short duration of diabetes, longer life expectancy, وما عندوش لسه cardiovascular disease, get lower A1C target, روح ناحية 6%. العكس لو مريض old age, long standing diabetes, who already got كل ال cardiovascular complications, relax your glycemic target towards 8%. For Nabil, I would recommend 7%. موافقين؟ 7% appropriate for Nabil ولا 6؟
7
ولا 8؟ 7. السؤال الثاني, how to achieve glycemic control for Nabil? These are the oral antidiabetic drugs that we do have. Biguanides and thiazolidinediones, both are insulin sensitizers by different mechanisms. Sulfonylurea, insulin secretagogue. DPP-4 inhibitor, secrete insulin and inhibit glucagon secretion. El Gadwal, the comparison between different oral antidiabetic agents. والconclusion بتاع الجدول ده ان مفيش perfect class, مفيش class of oral antidiabetic agents كاملا كما كنا واحد. Sulfonylureas have the advantage of being effective, inexpensive and safe. We are sure about long term safety of sulfonylureas. whereas the disadvantage of hypoglycemia and weight gain might be an issue. On the other hand, DPP-4 inhibitors and leptins have the advantage of less hypoglycemia and less weight gain. But the disadvantage of being expensive, and nobody can be sure about long-term safety of any recent molecule. Metformin, who are owner of oral antidiabetic agents, having the advantages of being inexpensive, no hypoglycemia, no weight gain. And some GIT side effects, but they wouldn't keep your patients. We claim that lactic acidosis is extremely, extremely rare. Thiazolidine diodes, the advantage of no hypoglycemia, ولكن التالت الليستة بتاعت الجليتازونز في الديسادفانتج ديزيز إديما ويت جين بون لوس سام كونفليكتنج ريزالتس أباوت سيفتي إن تيرمز أوف بلادر كانسر. دي الإكسبكتد A1C تارجت أوف ديفرنت أورال أجنتس. أنا بس عايز أقارن بين الأولدر ثيرابيز ميتفورمين سلفونيلوريا لايف ستايل انترفنشن أند نيور وان. The expected A1C reduction seemingly here more effective with metformin and sulfonylurea, not to forget the lifestyle intervention. DLASD ADA position statement that most of us believe in when treating type 2 diabetic patients is starting with lifestyle intervention and metformin from the day of diagnosis of type 2 diabetes. لو العيان سكره ما انصابش we add a second drug. These drugs are sulfonylureas, thiazolidine diodes, DPP-4 inhibitors, GLP-1 agonists, and insulin. One of these options, العيان سكره ما انصابش, we go to the three drug combination. We add a third agent. العيان سكره ما انصابش, لازم ندي insulin therapy. دي القصة, the scenario, the sequence of events when you are selecting an agent for type 2 diabetic patients. Different guidelines generated and released by the IDF a couple of years ago, IDF guidelines. The IDF guidelines that consider these parameters in choosing the oral agent or the treatment for diabetes, safety, efficacy, cost, and evidence behind the drug. Let me focus on the cost. The cost is an issue in selecting your drug. This is the geographical map. We are aware of the geographical world map. But do you know how this world map would appear from economic perspective? طبقا لدخل الفرد, this is the map according to the income of individuals living. احنا في الحتة اللي نطبقها دي. We all are living in a squeezed part of the world from economic perspectives. In IDF guidelines, in ESD or ADA, start with lifestyle and metformin, and then add other agents. ولكن هتلاقي في first line therapy, sulfonylurea is an option. ودي التفاصيل according to the IDF. Begin with metformin. You can also begin with sulfonylurea if you need rapid response where glucose levels are high. وآخر جزء هنا dual therapy. You are justified with a patient presenting with A1C of 9%, for example, or more, to start with two agents, including metformin. So for Nabil, let me focus on sulfonylurea and particularly glimepiride. Sulfonylureas can be classified into first generation. We are not using them anymore. Second generation, including glipenclamide, glipizide, and gliclazide. And third generation with glimepiride. Why glimepiride is a third generation? In the third generation, sulfonylurea. Well, on a molecular level, glimepiride binds to a different subunit of sulfonylurea receptor. Here the glipenclamide binding to the 140 kilodalton, glimepiride binding to the 65 kilodalton. And so what? We shouldn't care about biology. We should care about response This is translated into a clinical response here. What makes glycyrrhizide a third generation sulfonylurea is better control of post fasting and post prandial blood glucose thanks to better improvement of both first phase and second phase of insulin release. That hypertension, according to the evidence we have, the significant reduction of both fasting plasma glucose and post-prandial plasma glucose. برضو حتى molecular تاني في glycyrrhizide I want to stress on, which is called the extra pancreatic effect of glycyrrhizide or insulin myelinetic effect. في cells في حاجة اسمها blood flow transporter وظيفته ان هو be expressed on the plasma membranes to take glucose and get inside the cells. That transporter المسؤول عن الجلوكوز uptake by the cells. Glycyrrhizide increased translocation of this blood flow to the surface of the cell membrane. So, it can increase glucose uptake by cells. This is called insulin myelinetic effect. The elevated insulin, that effect of insulin. And this has been proven in experimental studies. Look at this study on experimental animals or rats. Adding glycyrrhizide increase the expression of GLUT4. Again, we are not treating rats. We're treating human. So this is the evidence from human studies. Very interesting study. Here, shifting patients from other sulfonylureas like glibenclamide or gliclazide here to glycyrrhizide and measuring HOMA-IR. HOMA-IR, the measurement of insulin resistance in human beings. With a significant reduction of HOMA-IR, more pronounced in less than BMI بتاعتهم more than 25 in obese people. In adequate evidence of that glycyrrhizide could improve insulin resistance. That's why, and because of the extra pancreatic effect of this molecule, you can find here a comparative bar chart of different sulfonylureas. In the fourth line baseline, in the whole in endogenous insulin secretion BZLDA, when you give the molecule. In the goes in the dark, in blood glucose lowering effect. واضح ان الجلايبيراي اقل واحد فيهم في انه بيريليز انسولين فروم بيتا سيلز. On the other hand, you will find here that glimepiride is the most effective in terms of getting blood glucose lower اللي يحل المعادله دي الاكسترا pancreatic effect of this molecule or the so called insulin myelinetic effect. Back to Naveen with his uncontrolled blood glucose. He is in this part of the guidelines on lifestyle therapy and metformin 2 grams per day. And we would think of add sulfonylurea or by the glycyrrhizide for today. What is the rationale again? Getting the insulin resistance ameliorated. Look at this study. Here is lifestyle intervention, getting HOMA-IR less, improving HOMA-IR. هنا متفورمين مونوثيرابي هنا متفورمين glycyrrhizide combination and as you see more and more decrease of HOMA-IR representing expressing and confirming the insulin sensitizing effect of this molecule. A translation and interpretation the results هو ده اللي بيهمنا adding the effect of metformin at monotherapy glimepiride at monotherapy on fasting plasma glucose, وهنا giving the combination of both metformin and glycyrrhizide. The effect on the hemoglobin A1c is the very same. Metformin monotherapy, glimepiride monotherapy, the combination of both, significant reduction of A1c. But let us ask, comparing metformin sulfonylurea with metformin thiazolidine diodes. This study answers very well the question. Here in the glimepiride metformin and here in the glimepiride pioglitazone, metformin pioglitazone combination. واضح انه بعد 26 اسبوع efficacy is comparable. يعني مفيش فرق في الـ A1C reduction ده بعد قد ايه؟ 26 اسبوع. طب وبعد 6 اسابيع و12 اسبوع و20 اسبوع في significant difference. يعني it needs time by TCDs to get the hemoglobin A1C to target reaching up to 4 or 5 months maybe. دي criteria اللي الـ ATASD حددها عشان تختار على اساسها الاورال او انتي دايابيتيك ايجنت ان جنرال. افيكاسي، هايبوغلايسيميا، ويت، سايد افكتس اند كوستس. And let me focus on hypoglycemia in this regard. Well, we have an evidence that the hypoglycemic risk of glimepiride is much lower than the glimepiride, the standard sulfonylurea degree. It's 7 times less in terms of hypoglycemic risk. What about other criteria? And if you want to mention weight, which is another maybe stigma of other sulfonylureas, well, this is the study that showed that yes, sometimes glimepiride can increase the weight, but when the BMI is low, this is lean person with BMI less than 20. With overweight people, according to this study, in 2 months, you can even get some lowering of the body mass index. Well, we have a reason, and they would say we have several reasons to add to the prescription of Labil 2 milligrams of glimepiride and titrate accordingly to reach good glycemic control. Let's move to Karima. And Karima has a different story. She is 61 years with 16 year history of type 2 diabetes on 2 grams of metformin and 6 milligrams of glimepiride. بتاخد maximum dose of metformin و6 milligrams. BMI 28, she is overweight, and she has controlled hypertension and dyslipidemia as well, with blood pressure 135 على 80. دي الدراكس اللي كريمة بتاخدها متفورمين 1 جرام twice daily 6 ميلي جرام of glimepiride and she is having a well controlled blood pressure with a combination of valsartan and lidocaine and her lipids are doing very well with rosuvastatin 10 ميلي جرام. But this is the glycemic profile of حاجة كريمة. سكر صاي 184 بعد الاكل بساعتين 216 A1C 7.9. She is having uncontrolled glycemia in spite of well-controlled blood pressure and lipids. How to achieve glycemic control for Karima? And I want to hear from you, please. هنعمل ايه الكريم؟ انا هرجع ليها. عايزين تعملوا فيها ايه؟ اديها انسولين. أديها بيزل أنسولين. أديها دي بي بي 4 انهبيتور. أزود جرعة بتاعت إيه دي؟ الجلميبرايد. كلكم واقفين؟ أنا سامع اعتراضات كثيرة جدا بيقولوا لك إن 6 ملي جرام ثيرابيوتيكالي إن ذا ماكسيمم إفكتيف دوز. يس، إن ليترشر يو كان reach 8 milligrams per deciliter, but no significant difference between 6 and 8. مش عارف رايك استاذ زيتي ايه؟ تمام جميل، الحمد لله على السلامة. يبقى في رأيين، رأي ان انا ممكن احط انسولين، ورأي ان انا ممكن احط دي بي بي 4 انهبيتورز. تعالوا نروح للجايد لاينز. هي كريمة في الحتة دي. She is on metformin and sulfonylurea combination. And according to the ADASD population statement, if the patient is not controlled here, you can add one of these agents. وأول واحد مكتوب هنا والترتيب هنا لا يعني أهمية الأجنت، هم محصلين وكاتبين كده تحت. ثياتوليدين دايونز، إيه رأيكم؟ عملي لا. وأنت برضه ليه لا؟ مفيش حد آه. ممكن هي ممكن تعجبني برضو. Efficacy wise, yes, we have an evidence that a combination of glyburide metformin says it is effective. والhypoglycemic risk في الاستاذ دي على فكرة ما زادش كتير مش significant increase ولكن وألف لكن giving it is indeed to this elderly postmenopausal lady I wouldn't be comfortable صاحبي I wouldn't be comfortable with adding glitazones for this lady it can be appropriate for other situations so it's effective yeah but safety should come first الحالة الثانية هي في الحتة دي بتاخد metformin وسلفونايل يوريا one of the options is to add DPP-4 inhibitors yes and this is the evidence a smart combination of glyburide metformin sitagliptin or glyburide metformin vildagliptin has shown efficacy and safety in clinical studies ولكن based على الكيرف ده والجراف ده اللي شفناه من شوية We all know the natural history of type 2 diabetes في progressive beta cell failure يوم بتشخص type 2 diabetes the day of diagnosis عندك 50% من beta cells already has gone With years بيحصل more deterioration of beta cell function whatever the drug you're giving وبالتالي based على دي زي ما قال زميلي انا ممكن افكر ادي انسولين وزي ما قلنا من ساعه ولا ساعتين ما وقفش الاورال وادي توتال انسولين ريبليسمنت في الحاله دي وي وود ثينك اوف كيبينج اورال هايبوغلايسيميك دراجز اند جيفينج وان شوت اوف فيس اوف انسولين ات نايت والسؤال في الحاله دي وفي الست دي وفي مدام كريم اوقف أوقف الأورال ولا لا؟ أوقف الجلايبيرايد ولا لا؟ أقلل الجرعة. إيه رأيكم؟ طب ما وقفوش ليه؟ أستاذ الدكتور عباس حرام يقول لي ما أنت وقفت هتقعد تزود في الإنسولين دوز. صحيح عشان كده whenever you add على 2 جرام متفورمين والستة ملي جلايبيرايد بيسر انسولين as adding glargine please do not stop both oral agents وحقول ليه قال الستدي اللي قالت في ارم ياخد انسولين وتايتريت الدوز لغاية ما تظبط وارم تاني ياخد انسولين ومعاه جلايبيرايد لغاية ما تظبط عارفين الفرق ده في ايه؟ في الانسولين دوز needed to reach a good glycemic control. It's 38% less when keeping glyburide with insulin. If I قللت جرعة الانسولين thanks to the insulin mimetic effect of this molecule. طب ليه بقول كده؟ طب والاذر سلفونيلوريز بصوا على الستادي دي comparing glyburide, glypizide, glibenclamide, سلفونيلوريز as an add-on with insulin. ودي الانسولين ريكوايرمنت عمود السوائل ده بتاع اسكندريه اللي ما خدوش غير انسولين بس ما خدوش معاه سلفونيلوريا اول سلفونيلوريا كود ديكريت ذا انسولين ريكوايرمنت ولكن الجلايبيرايد اقل انسولين ريكوايرمنت في اول سلفونيلوريا again thanks to the insulin mimetic effect of the molecule another study هنا الميتفورمين مع الانسولين ده الانسولين ريكوايرمنتس وده متفورمين وجلايبيرايد مع انسولين ده ليست انسولين ريكوايرمنتس جيفن ويذ انسولين اخر حاجه في الحته دي دول الخمسه كرايتيريا اوف ذا اي دي اي اس دي اللي بنختار على اساسهم علاج السكر لو طلب من حضرتك تحط كرايتيريا نمره 6 تحط ايه؟ يعني بعتوا لك قالوا لك عايزين تحط حاجه سادسه حاجه سادسه نحط ايه نحط يا بيه ما نقاش الشوط الاتش ده جاي في الايه في السيفتي في الادفيرس ايفنتس لكن دلوقتي ما فيش دواء سكر بيبقى ابروفد غير لما يعمل ستاديز لتبرك ساحه هذا الدواء من
Cardiovascular
effects. Yes, cardiovascular effects are very important to consider when you think of oral anti-diabetic agents. مش بس ضبط سكر لكن safety and efficacy in terms of cardiovascular effects. Ischemic preconditioning باختصار وببساطة هي a protective mechanism that if the patient is subjected to severe ischemia or myocardial ischemia بتقلل الانفاركت سايز. قادي العيان اللي عنده intact ischemic preconditioning وده عيان عنده abolished وinhibited ischemic preconditioning. Data بتقول السلفونيلوريز بتinhibit abolished ischemic preconditioning. دي one of the studies comparing glibenclamide with glimepiride. As you're seeing here, a glimepiride زي البلاسيبو. مفيش inhibition, مفيش block للإسكيميك preconditioning unlike glibenclamide according to this study. يبقى safety-wise, cardiovascular safety is well established in glimepiride. لكن ده في كمان cardiovascular advantages of this molecule. According to this study, after 3 months, you can get lower lipoprotein small a by one homocysteine with the lack of cardiovascular markers, cardiovascular risk markers. لما بيقلوا يبقى cardiovascular risk بيقل. After 12 months, you have significant reduction of total and cholesterol and LDL cholesterol with glimepiride. العكس ده بيزود ال HDL وال adiponectin and as you know both are good cardiovascular markers. لما بيزيدوا بيقل ال cardiovascular risk. Another study with decreasing A1C with the use of glimepiride and increasing adiponectin level over time in this study. Lastly, أساتذتك أعزائي أساتذتي وإخواتي to take a home message. The effective management of diabetes can significantly reduce the diabetic complications. Diet and exercise remain the foundation in the type 2 diabetes management. And metformin, unless contraindicated, and if tolerable, should be the optimal first-line anti-diabetic agent. Yet, we have a convincing evidence confirming the safety and efficacy of sulfonylureas. As used, remain a cornerstone in the management of type 2 diabetes مع عادتش لموضة قديمة. In type 2 diabetic patients uncontrolled of metformin, adding a sulfonylurea is an attractive and evidence-based option. And our molecule for today, glimepiride, the third generation sulfonylurea, has a unique dual mode of action, pancreatic and extra-pancreatic, fast and sustained blood glucose lowering effect, clinically proven safety profile, ideal for combination with insulin and with all other oral anti-diabetic drugs, and does have benefits beyond glycemic control. And to end up and finish my presentation, احنا شفنا كتير النهارده الجايد لاينز ديت هشاور بس على العنوان عنوانها patient centered approach.